similar to spider guard with the foot in the bicep here. When I started playing up pain, I wasn't able to put my foot in the bicep because my leg was so fucked I couldn't do like a 90 degree angle with it. So the lapel's a little bit closer to you. And sometimes it's easier to grab onto. You don't have control over his arm then when you do get it. But when you do get your foot in on that lapel, you can control the shoulder pretty good. It can be pretty hard for him to break the grip as well. And a bit confusing too, if he hasn't been used to someone controlling his lapel, it can be a bit frustrating. So we're just going to go from standing, just grab the bottom of the lapel, harder for him to break it. But if he can get a good grip on this here, when you're on the ground, easier for him to pull back. So trying to get where it's hard for him to get a handful of the grip. You're only controlling one side. Same with spider guard here, you're on the ground, you have your foot and the bicep on one side. You want to control something on the other side of his body to make it more difficult. So, it's going to take a grip here on the lapel. And then, pulling guard like normal, step in halfway between you and him. Arse goes down, foot goes up. Foot into the lapel here. Pull the grips, and then it depends where we go from there. For the moment, we'll just go that far, and then we're going to tidy up with a few other options. Based on which side you want. So you get the lapel, you get the collar here, just down, foot in, and pulling forward straight away if you can, and we just go foot here. Wherever your foot ends up for a moment, that's fine. We're just getting to the ground with this control, keeping the tension, controlling both sides of his body, and then we'll look at what to do with our other leg now once we get the hang of that. Alright, should just give it a try then too. Just one, two. Sometimes if he moves enough, you might miss the lapel, which is going to be as your other foot, or sometimes if he blocks your leg, then that can be the case. So as you're going for it, if you miss, you sometimes can get this one in on it, just for a moment, and then pass back the other one, and go. But better, again, is timing-wise, just don't leave a gap in it where he can attack. So if you feel that he's waiting to grab your legs as you're coming up, you grab two, yeah, if you see that he's waiting for that, we can do something to get his hands up. So if you think he's gonna grab a leg, up and over, and just wrap his head. Okay, from there you could try taking down. This grip is pretty annoying. Normally he'll straighten up and try to pull it off. If he goes up that way, he might just jump a close guard and finish it. As he's spinning out, bang, we go again. If you get this up and over here secure enough, you can jump a close guard and start attacking the neck. Ezekiel chokes and such coming inside it. But just in and of itself, it's annoying. As it comes up, he'll probably, you don't need to move your head, he'll probably try to block it a little bit there, and then we're down. Okay, but if we miss it, or if we think he's gonna block this one, up and over, you can start trying to take the legs out from him. You can jump the close guard, keeping the control, start placing your hand through the grip, and start to attack his neck and such. But just in and of itself, it's pretty nice. So just give that a try, guys. Just go into dummy one, you think he's going to block it, up and over, and see what you can do with this control. All right, give it a try on two. One, two. Hex guard, with the foot on the near hip, like the curl guard is set. Just bring it up this way, tiny bit. So, use the momentum. Foot comes in, pull over to the side and down a little bit, and your outside foot here comes onto the inside. Catch his knee, step down, and just kick up. And up and over. So you're using the lapel on the shoulder, pull the shoulder forward and down, and then we're kicking his hip up. So up and over here, start to step on him, and just straight up. Just use the momentum off the pull and through his. Alright, give it a try on two. Just one, two. Okay, guys, so the idea behind that is using the momentum off the guard, but bringing him over and then attacking when he's over it. If you miss the momentum or you have better balance and he stays back here in front of you, best to keep the distance now. It's hard to pull him over that side. We're going to start using our left leg. But you can still use it like you would in traditional or normal X guard here. Right? If you're here and pulling forward, you can do the same thing with the lapel. To start trying to pull him forward and do the same thing, coming underneath them, tidying up your feet and kicking them over. This one only works if you can put the foot in onto his belly. It only works if you can put the foot in onto the belly. Some guys are asking, if you don't break his posture, what you do? If you stand back up, Jim, you're going to have to go over onto the far leg here, maybe hold on to the leg a bit tighter, or this one, depending on what grip you prefer, foot comes inside. And then you have, if you want, you can let go of the lapel and do a normal X guard, or if you prefer, you can keep this lapel and do X guard with the lapel. But once again, once we pull the guard here, if we didn't get quite what we wanted, this foot here, our left leg, you can use it on the ground to kick him up and over. You can use it on the hip to control the distance. You can use it, if this leg is in much closer, you can use it like Delahiva here,
get your grip like the Leandro Low on the pants on the very bottom, kick up and over and drag yourself underneath and start going into your X guard that way. So use the left leg. Try to keep him on this side of your body if you can. If he goes around to the other side, keep it like same with spider guard. You keep your leg on the bottom straight. Try to keep in here, but try to keep his posture broken. You don't want to let him drive you up here back to the center and shake the leg off. So as much as possible, stay on your side. It's pretty hard for him to get out of it if you can keep it here, because this is such a strong grip with your legs straight. Just make sure you have the sole of your foot in the lapel. If you start putting it on the material, sometimes the referee will give you a disadvantage and readjust it, so just keep it on the lapel if you can. So we pull the guard, we don't quite get what we want. We're on this side, keep the leg straight, keep this leg free. If we want, we can come back in, kick and bring him forward. Foot in the hip to keep the distance. Della heave, grab the pants and drag arse underneath. Start doing like Leandro, pulling it through that way. Or if he comes in with the left leg, you can start doing a reverse Della heave. So basically a lot of the standard guards, but just with our foot in the lapel this time and working off. Alright, so just give a few a try, guys, get a feel for them, and then we'll do a few transitions after. Alright, on two, guys, one, two. Okay, guys, same again. So after pulling the guard, coming around, we didn't get quite get where we wanted him to. He stayed back a little bit. Or maybe we got the guard from on the ground. Maybe he was leading with one side and with his chest forward a lot. And then normally with the left leg, he would go left lapel. You weren't quite able to get control of the sleeve like you wanted to get a guard there, but you got the lapel. Just straight back with it, and then immediately I've no grip on this side. So if you can come in and get some sort of control on that side of this body. But so we have our two grips here, and we're using our left foot, hip, Della heave, or straight through in and onto the X guard. Anytime this one here doesn't have enough purchase on it, again, it's good to go to the far hip and wrap this leg. Keep him off balance a little bit with this one, but there's a good chance he's going to posture now. And as he goes to posture, we can come in underneath and you can start to sweep him from partial X guard. Again, you do this without the lapel, just start knocking him over or go for the X guard, or you can keep this grip here and pass it to your other hand that's underneath his ankle. And that's just good for an extra control. Annoy him a little bit. Sometimes you can pull him down and tip him over this side. Come up on top and finish him. Normally you'll sweep him backwards. So right into the X guard. Normally you try sweeping backs this way. Again, it's not as strong a sweeping position as if you have the foot on your shoulder, but you have this extra control here that makes it annoying for him and a little bit harder to escape. Sometimes what I do is pass this to the other grip and then try to get rid of this foot. So pushing him, getting him off balance, and get the foot up and over your body, and back in here, clamping in a little bit, hand to the hip, hip escape, and just drag him down. Good thing about this is when we come up on top, you go back down, trying to fight out. When we come up on top, keep your elbow tight, kick over a little bit, and up here. And now you have his leg clamped. It's really, really annoying. And if you attack with your left hand, like stuff like bread cutter chokes and such, it might take a while to get done for stalling. So it's a good way of stalling the matchup, controlling him if he has a good guard himself, and just frustrating him and getting good position. All right, just one last action. So after pulling guard, we fucked it. So we pull guard here, didn't quite get him all the way over the side like we wanted, but we've got enough that we have him in the next guard here. Not enough for a sweep, but we have a bit of an X guard. Swapping the foot in, passing the lapel over. Sometimes we can sweep him here, pulling him in, getting his elbow, push all the way over. Sometimes we can pass the lapel, get his knee down a little bit, push up and over, and grab on here. If you get it far enough, you can go behind him and start taking the back. Usually, he'll try to face you again, start coming in with the underhook and such. Hip escape underneath them. Clamp your elbow, open over, and keep it. Punch his knee to the ground, keep his hip down, start the mind, attack the neck. Sometimes you can start attacking the arm as well. But very, very annoying position to start coming out of. If you have the grip down here near his leg, he can start kicking out. You go back over that way, you kick your leg straight down towards the ground. The pressure goes into your hand and the grip starts to get a bit loose. If you get the lapel all the way around the back of his hamstring and he starts kicking out, most of the tension just goes straight into his own leg. So you can hold him pretty good here and just push him. Alright, give it a try. 1, 2.